Ken Corla. Taoiseach, the CEE schemes, the length and breadth of this country has transformed rural towns and villages and given exceptional support to charitable groups and organisations. They have worked extremely well for years until the government started tinkering with them, constantly changing the rules and regulations to such an extent that their future has been put in jeopardy. Sponsors are being scared off by the increasing demanding conditions being placed on them, the supervisors they employ to run these schemes and the participants themselves. We have seen evidence of this in Galway City earlier this year, Taoiseach, where a project that gave valuable experience was closed by the sponsoring group. They probably are not the first, and in my opinion, they certainly won't be the last sponsor to pull out of a CEE scheme or decide against opting into one because of the barriers that are being placed in their way. While this government and the Department of Social Protection claim to be supportive of the work being done through community employment schemes, their actions suggest otherwise. Now, the only satisfied party is the department itself. The time participants are allowed to spend on the scheme and, in turn, the amount of training has been reduced. Costs have risen, but cuts to the budget for materials hasn't been restored. This has resulted in a fall in productivity of the schemes, and it also means that there's no sustainability of service. Community employment schemes are among the few subventions that the state offers to voluntary groups whose own sustainability often depends on the work being carried out by the participants on the scheme. But the constant changing of work practices of participants, supervisors and the obligations of sponsors have diminished the appeal of these schemes for everyone. It's funny, Taoiseach, that the department should constantly trot out the line that the people taking part in these schemes are not employed by the department, keeping them at arm's length, yet it's the department that keeps laying down new demands on how they should be run. I'd like to pay special tribute here to the supervisors, who are the linchpins of the schemes. Indeed, many voluntary sponsoring groups and sponsoring chairmen are largely unaware of the full responsibility be placed on them because of the efficiency of the supervisors and looking after all aspects of the schemes. Also, the department don't seem to acknowledge the vast array of work being undertaken by supervisors and how constantly changing procedures and requirements make this role extremely difficult. This is a group of people without pensions, contracts of indefinite duration or any pay increases in the last 10 years. Taoiseach, despite Labour Court recommendations, an abandoned benchmarking procedure and a drawn-out process regarding pensions, which is currently being examined by the Community Sector High Level Forum. Having spoken with a number of supervisors, I know that they don't hold out any great hope of a positive outcome regarding pensions from this forum. Taoiseach, will you today acknowledge the tremendous work being done by CEE schemes around the country and ensure that the department right around for supervisors by providing them with a proper contract, a pay increase and pension rights which are long overdue?
I certainly want to join with Deputy Grealish in acknowledging the value of CEE schemes. We're all familiar with them as TDs in our constituencies. I'm very familiar with them as the Foreign Minister for Social Protection. And I'm also aware of the fact that the community employment system was established by my party many decades ago, and it's something that we're very proud of having done, having established community employment. I don't think so, actually. I shall double check that, but certainly by us in government, if that's the case, anyway. It started off, as you know, as a different scheme, which was called social employment and moved into community employment. To answer the deputy's question, obviously CEE has a huge value. It has a dual value, providing employment and training opportunities for people, and then, of course, secondary to that, providing important community services as well. The number of people on community employment schemes at the moment stands at 21,956. That's down about 2% from last year. And it does make sense, of course, when the economy is growing, when there is more employment, when there is fewer people who are unemployed, that the number of people on schemes goes down. And as we need them again, as unemployment goes up and employment falls, they get expanded in terms of numbers. On the issue of the CEE supervisors, I'm advised they've been seeking, through their trade union representatives, the allocation of Exchequer funding to implement a Labour Court recommendation which was issued on the 22nd of July 2008 relating to the provision of a pension scheme. CE scheme supervisors are not employees of the state or government. They're employees, in some cases, of private companies and, in some cases, of community and voluntary sector bodies. The taxpayer, therefore, is not responsible for funding their pensions for such employees, where companies, even when the companies in question are reliant on state funding for their operations. The scheme applies, for example, the same would apply, for example, to commercial entities who do work for the state, to individual contractors who do work for the state, through semi-state companies as well. And as the Deputy will know, Labour Court findings are made on the employer, and as the employer is not the state, the Labour Court finding was made not on this. It's very hard to answer questions in this house sometimes, Ken Corla. So as the Labour Court finding applies to the employer and the state is not the employer, the Labour Court finding doesn't apply to the state, it applies to the legal employer. And one thing we have to do as a government and as a house is always look out for the taxpayer and respect the taxpayer. And if we were to take on the pension liabilities for people who are not public servants, who work for a voluntary body or a private body, obviously the impact and the liability on the taxpayer would be very great indeed.
Deputy Grealish.
Taoiseach, I totally disagree with your answer. The tremendous work that the CE schemes do around this country, and you're correct, there's over nearly 22,000 people employed in these schemes. These schemes would not be in operation only for the supervisors. And there's CE schemes that's run through local authorities and Galway County Council, and Rudas Nguetata. The supervisors that are over them schemes are on pensions and will get full pension rights. So, Taoiseach, I totally disagree. You have to get solve this issue. The supervisors are employed through, I know the clubs are there, through the CE schemes, but they're administered by the Euro Department, the Department of Social Protection that your government controls. And the department constantly put down the rules and regulations regarding these schemes, tell them how they should be run. They're bringing in new procedures by the week that these supervisors that have to implement. And at the end of the day, they're entitled to absolutely nothing when they retire. I know of one supervisor that can't even get a mortgage, Taoiseach, because on the pittance that he's been paid. So, Taoiseach, you have to right this wrong. The supervisor should be brought in under the department, they should be entitled to pensions, and they should get pensions, and they should be put on proper contracts of work, Taoiseach. And I ask that you personally intervene and resolve this issue as a matter of urgency, Taoiseach.
Taoiseach, to conclude on this matter.
The same would apply for lots of fields of endeavour, lots of businesses and lots of work. There are lots of examples of where the government sets the rules, sets the regulations, designs the contract. But that doesn't mean that the government is required then to cover the pension liability of the people who work for that body
or
work for that company. And of course, it is always open to individuals to make provision for their pension. You can do it by paying into a pension fund, you can do it by paying into PRSA, and that is, of course, what public servants do. If you're a teacher or a civil servant and you work for the public service, you make a contribution into the public pension fund. In terms of this particular issue, as deputies may be aware, it is currently being examined by the Community Sector High Level Forum, which is chaired by the Department of Public Expenditure and Reform. The Department of Employment Affairs and Social Protection, Health, Education, Skills, Housing, Planning, Local Government is represented on this group, as is the agency PUBL, SIP2 and Impact. The forum last met on the 23rd of November 2017. And a paper outlining the costs was presented. The unions have agreed to review and revert as soon as possible, and following on from this, a meeting will be arranged between the trade unions and Minister Pascal Donoghue as Minister for Finance. It's important to point out that CE supervisors may qualify for a state pension, either means-tested or contributory.
Thank you, Taoiseach. That concludes leaders' questions.